Hey, what's up guys, welcome back, you're watching for today. So the legendary custom ROM Lineageos has finally started to roll out the stable Lineageos version 22.2, which is based on the Google stable QPR1 source code. This update is now officially rolling out for hundreds of different devices across various OEMs. Even the custom GSI world has ported this build for non-official devices, which I flashed on my Nothing Phone 1 and it's booted successfully. In today's video, we'll check out the new changes in this version of Lineageos 22.2. At the end of this video, we'll show you which official devices got this update and how you can flash this build on unofficial devices. So make sure to watch this video until the end. Now without further delay, let's get started. The first obvious change is this new update is based on the new source base of Google's latest Android 15 QPR1 stable codes. This is an Android 15 based update with the LineageOS version 22.2. LineageOS still using their legendary Easter egg for this build too. Security patch is from the December 2024. Kernel version will vary for different devices, but since I'm using the GSI build, the kernel version will be the same as the stock primary ROM. The build date of this new version is from the January 1st, 2025. Now we will check the major changes of this update. The first new change is the new music application. The previous build uses the LineageOS 11 music player, but this time it's updated to the latest version 12. This version has some interesting features. There are three tabs at the bottom of the application. First one is shows the recent activities. That is the list of the recently played music tracks. The next is the search tab, which is now more improved than previous build. Last is the library. This music player now has the inbuilt music visualizer. Just tap on the icon and you get the music visualizer built in the player. We also get the inbuilt audio effects music equalizer. Just tap on the icon and tune your music audio directly within the music player. The effects of the music visualizers are also improved as compared to the previous builds. Design-wise, this app features the modern material you design. It offers the proper landscape and tablet experience and supports the streaming protocols like HLS, Dash and the smooth streaming. The next major improvement in the update is the addition of Linageos Camelot. Previously, Linageos didn't have any inbuilt PDF reader, so had to rely on the third-party applications. Thankfully, Android 15 has a robust PDF reader library inbuilt in the operating system, making it easier the Linageos team to develop a PDF reader application. The new PDF reader app is called as the Camelot, and it's based on the same Jetpack PDF support library that is used by the Google Chrome and the files by the Google. Now after downloading any PDF file from the browser, you can directly view it without needing the third-party applications. Some system inbuilt applications have been updated as per the change log, including the Sealed Vault and the Eater. However, I am not sure about the specific functions of these applications in the operating system. The WebView has been updated to the Chromium 131.0.6778. There are many underhood code changes had been done, but I cannot able to show you them visually in the video. But I have added the changelog in the video description, so you can check them out. This new update is now officially available for more than 100 devices by LineageOS. Devices from almost all the OEMs, whether they are old or the new, are getting this stable update. I had provided the link to these devices in the video description where you can download and install the update. But if your device is not in the list, don't worry. I have provided the custom GSI build ported by the developer and for the ARM64AB devices. I tried it using the DSU application on my Nothing Phone 1 and it's booted and it's working fine. So it should work for most devices with the mentioned system partition scheme. If you don't know how to install the custom GSI using the DSU loader application, please watch the video tutorial links given in the video description. You can flash this with or without root access easily on any device without affecting your primary ROM. Later, if you feel this build is stable enough for your device, you can manually flash it via fast boot mode. Alternatively, you can use this as a dual boot alongside your primary ROM using the DS loader. You can switch between the primary and the custom GSI ROM anytime with just one click. That's the beauty of DS installation. So that's it for today guys. Hope you liked our work. Then please do like and share this video. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming content. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye bye.